Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Check out this unknown liquid. What do you think it is? It looks to me like it could be honey or maple syrup, but how can we know for sure? How can we tell the difference between different substances? To start, we can look for different ways to describe it, such as amber in color or flows slowly. We could even test its boiling point or calculate its density. All of these different ways that we can describe a substance are called its properties, and they can help us determine what type of matter we are looking at in this video. In this lesson, we will look at the two main categories of properties: physical properties and chemical properties. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to describe and identify physical and chemical properties. All matter has properties that can be used to identify the substance. For example, the liquid from the opening. What are some things you notice that can help you identify it? Well, it has an amber color, and when you carefully watch it pour, it is thick and moves slowly, meaning it has a high viscosity. Viscosity is a measure of a fluid's resistance to flow. If you think about those two properties, golden color and a thick, slow flow, can you narrow down the identity of the substance to a few options? Given those two properties, it could be honey, maple syrup, and maybe there are a few other substances it could be too. If we really wanted to further narrow it down, we could test its density, boiling point, etc. Eventually, we would be able to confidently say that the liquid is honey. When describing a substance, there are a multitude of properties that can be used, and the combination of those properties is unique to every substance. For example, water would have very different properties from this honey, like lower viscosity and a colorless appearance. Some properties can be seen while others must be tested or observed in experiments. All properties fall into one of two categories: physical properties and chemical properties. Thinking back to the honey earlier in this lesson, we were able to easily describe its color and viscosity. Color and viscosity are examples of physical properties. Physical properties are properties that can be observed without changing the chemical composition, meaning you don't change what the substance is, but rather make observations based on what you see. Can you think of some more examples of physical properties? Some examples include color, shape, and mass. What about density? Can you find the density of this metal without changing it? Yes, you can, by calculating the volume and measuring the mass. What about boiling point and freezing point? Using a thermometer, you can measure the boiling point and freezing point of a liquid, and, as we learned in a previous lesson, there is no change in the substance during phase changes. The particles are just moving slower or faster, causing the state of matter to change. This means that boiling point and freezing point are also physical properties. Another example of a physical property is the ability to conduct electricity. Have you ever tried the good old lemon or potato as a battery electricity experiment? Well, in these situations, the lemon or potato are not changing while the electricity flows through them. This means conductivity is a physical property. These two flasks contain the same exact liquid. Looking at them, we can determine two physical properties: color, blue, and volume. The flask on the left has a volume of 100 milliliters, and the one on the right has a volume of 75 milliliters. Even though both color and volume are physical properties, when the amount of the substance changed, the color stayed the same while the volume did not. Color is a specific type of physical property called an intensive property, while volume is an extensive property. All physical properties are either intensive or extensive properties. Intensive properties are properties such as color, density, and freezing point. These are all properties that remain the same no matter how much of the substance is present. On the other hand, mass and volume are examples of extensive properties. These are properties that depend on the amount of the substance and will change accordingly. A substance's chemical properties are a little harder to notice than its physical properties. A chemical property is the ability of a substance to change its composition to produce new substances, meaning that at the atomic level, you end up with a different substance than you started with. That means chemical properties can only be observed when the chemical composition of the substance changes. Examples of chemical properties include a substance's reactivity with other chemicals, such as water and oxygen, its flammability, and its ability to rust. Where physical properties can be divided into intensive and extensive properties, all chemical properties are the same, no matter how much of the matter is present. Why do you think that is? As we went through the lesson today, we learned about physical properties, such as color and mass, and chemical properties, such as reactivity and flammability. We also discussed how these properties can be used to identify a substance. In our next lesson, we will learn about changes to these properties as we discuss physical and chemical changes. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. Hey!